You are about to see hockey history, the 1972 Canada-Russia series. Their best against our best. It was a thrill of a lifetime to play in that series and a thrill again to watch it on tape these many years later. Several of my teammates on that club have watched this video and their comments are interesting. Yvon Cornoyer, the fast skating star of the Montreal Canadiens. Bobby Clark, who centered the line I played on. Serge Savard, the tough defenseman who never played a losing game against the Soviets. And of course, Allan Eagleson, the man who brought it all together. And so, the stage was set. Four games in Canada, four in the Soviet Union. The series started on a hot summer night at the Forum in Montreal. Relive the greatest series in hockey history as we hear again the voice of the late Foster Hewitt.
I can't recall any game that I've ever been at where you can just feel the tension and it keeps building up, and it's very warm in the Forum tonight. And at the same time, the fans are really on their toes. They hardly can wait to see the beginning of this game. There's the official face-off.
We in the press and everyone in Canada was convinced we were going to win eight games in a row. All we felt we had to do was show up, step on the ice, and beat the Russians eight straight.
We had assembled, I thought, was a terrific hockey team. And I knew that I was prepared mentally to play them, and in fact, I wanted to get at it. But of course, we had no idea that they were such a great hockey team.
As is the custom in international hockey, you'll see that they all skate towards each other and exchange a little pennant and a crest. I don't know whether this will be a feature of international hockey if it continues on for years to come, but it's certainly a very appropriate thing for this first game.
Does anyone know whose voice that is? That's Brian Connacher. Brian Connacher. Forgot that he was in it.
And the game is underway with Petrov having cleared it into the Canadian zone. Canada clear on the boards, but not out. It's Bergman coming up now with a pass to center ice. Esposito going up over the line into the corner, shot right across the goal mouth. Bergman keeps it in. Mihovlich missed it back of the net. There's Cornoyer. There's a pass to Foligno. Feet stop. Here's a shot right in front of the goal. Mihovlich knocked it into the net.
No. Espo
it's
got
a beautiful
it.
Setup here. Now look at this. Number five, Brad Park, gets the puck across the goal mouth. Frank has to control it, but he flips it right through the pass. Oh, it's banged out of the thing by number seven. Phil Esposito came across and picked that up.
Bergman and Parker playing up. It's back to Henderson. He scores! A quick shot from the faceoff. Henderson fired at home.
The Russians missed this faceoff cleanly. Goes to the right. Clark takes it out. Ellis back to Henderson. Henderson, a quick snapshot for the right corner. Tretiak had the angle cut off, but it was a perfect shot.
30 seconds, first goal was
well, I remember even after I scored the goal, I went back to the bench and Ronnie and Bobby Clark and I were sitting there, and I can specifically remember saying, this is going to be a long, long series. I mean, you just knew it. I mean, they were very composed. They never got up. I mean, just the way they passed the puck and their conditioning was incredible.
Another try, the shot goes wide and bounces over to the side. Vladiev trying to clear to the corner. It's centered right in front. They score! From that left side, they finally found the corner of the net. And, of course, it was Zeman that was the marksman who stood right off the side of the net.
Now, Zeman has looked terrific in the practices so far here. And watch him park himself just off to the far side of Dryden. Dryden now has to concentrate. And he throws it right up top. Not a goalie in the world would have stopped it. There's a look at Bobby Orr, and I bet he wishes he was in this game.
I'll bet he can hardly contain himself. Mihailov nearly got loose, gets it over to Petrov, back to Mihailov, right in the clear, oh, right in, they score! Petrov getting the rebound, and it's all tied up. Petrov gets that goal on a breakaway.
Petrov gets the puck up. Now watch Petrov, comes in behind. Now watch the pursuit. Terrific concentration, puts a backhand over Dryden's pad, up into the top.
Puck is back on the Canadian defense. Seeling couldn't reach the pass, and they're still missing that team play. Down the right side, Rattel lobbed this one from the side. Maltsev recovers the puck, cleared on the right side without even looking. Kharlamov goes down over the line, cutting in around Ori, a shot, he scores! Kharlamov went right around the Canadian defense, Ori, and picked the corner to give the Soviet a 3-2 lead.
This is a tremendous individual effort. He beats Ori to the outside. Now he has to start cutting towards the net. Now watch Dryden come out and try to play it. He has to get the puck over to the far side, and he beats Dryden on the long side, right there between when he goes to take his pads open.
Canada broke into a 2-0 lead early in the first period. The Soviets came back strong and tied it up before the first period was over, and then took the lead in this second period. Kharlamov, a very tricky player, gets it, scores! Kharlamov let a bullet drive go, and it beat Dryden to the top left-hand corner. It had Dryden beaten all the way, and it's 4-2
for the
Soviets.
That'll nullify anybody who says that the Soviets can't shoot. Kharlamov, one of their top players. Look at this quick shot. Now he catches Dryden back in the net. I honestly think Dryden wasn't set on that shot. I don't think he ever expected him to shoot that puck at that time.
Henderson for Canada centers out to Ellis. He tries to score! Clark deflected that one into the net. Clark from Henderson and Ellis.
That was a beautiful shot by Ronnie Ellis because he was smart enough to keep the puck on the ice. He's shooting from a perfect area. Bobby Clark parked right on the goal step, and he just tips it in, and is he happy? A big goal for Canada. I think that goal by Bobby Clark has shaken the Soviets' confidence a little bit here. They seem to go back in a bit of a shell.
Bernoyer had a quick shot from the faceoff there and just missed by 2 inches. Bernoyer gets it back to Mahovlin. They're really battling. A pass goes astray. Blinov comes right back for the Soviets. Passes to Mihailov, coming in on goal. Oh, he scores! Mihailov went right in to score and give the Soviet a 5-3 lead.
This goal's an example of not having coordinated team play. No one was sure who to take Mihailov, so what's he do? He keeps the puck. He walks right into the slot. Now they back away from him. He goes into the middle. He's all alone now. He's walking into the prime scoring area. What's he do? He puts a good backhand in the far corner. Dryden didn't have much of a chance on that goal.
There's one thing about the Soviets, they really can put that puck into the net when they get a chance.
You know what, Kenny Dryden, which was a great Hall of Famer, a great hockey player, a great goaltender, could never put a great game against the Russian.
Puck rolls back into the Soviet zone. Vladiev deflected one off Shadrin's stick. Yakushev got up over the line. Here they're closing in. Seaman gets right in, he scores! Seaman went rushing right in to score for the Soviet.
This is what the Soviets do. They score in bunches. They'll get you when you're down a little bit. Now, Seaman just coasts in here. He miscues here with the puck. He's tripped up a little bit right there, but it comes back up to his stick. Dryden has already made his move, and he buries it in the far corner.
Soviets leading 6-3 in a tremendous hockey game here, the first of a series that promises to be sensational. Now Lapointe goes up, getting in close, right in. And again, that Tretiak was steady and covered the angle. Down the left side for Seaman. Seaman, number 11, gets it back to Yakushev, who's knocked down. Puck is on the boards with Henderson losing it to Shadrin, a roller right in front, they score! Yakushev cutting right in front to make it 7-3. Yakushev.
This is absolutely a beautiful goal, because is there ever a lot of beautiful work along the boards? Look at the stick work here. He makes two beautiful moves. Yakushev holds him on the post, goes with a big backhand. Yakishev is 6'1", and it looks like Frank Mahovlet scoring that goal.
Let's get to Toronto. I want to see Kernoye score.
Mounting all the time, although it's been a fever pitch right from the beginning. The Petrov grabbed the Esposito, Cashman goes in and carries his man down, and he wasn't a bit particular how he took Lechenko out of the play. Lechenko kicked at the puck to get it out. It's brought in by Cashman, a rugged performer. Esposito was dumped on the play, and it looks like there's going to be a penalty to the Soviet. The goalkeeper's leaving. Yeah, here's Esposito. Right by the door! Esposito. Phil Esposito has scored for Canada.
Watch the work that Cashman does here. He does an excellent job of getting Phil Esposito the puck. Now look at the quick move across the goal mouth. And he jams it in the far side. Absolutely super goal by Phil Esposito. Never leave him on the doorstep.
Most guys take their time getting up. They get back to the bench and get hecked from the coach. He takes his time getting up, and the puck comes from right in front of the net.
Look at this.
Oh, the goal scorers.
Garshanov and Esposito facing off. He kicked it to the blue line, and it's shot down the ice by Lechenko. Park goes in back to the Canadian goal. 40 seconds left of the penalty. Up the center ice. Park over the right side. Kernoye coming right in. He's just scored! Kernoye!
Absolutely beautiful play. Brad Park saw Ivan Kornoye breaking on the right wing. And you'll see Kornoye turn the jets on. Now look at the pass. Rink wide. And Kornoye is gone. And he breaks in. Good position. And he fires a good hard shot through that opening in Tretiak's legs, and it goes into the back of the net. Brad Park again, a beautiful pass on Cornoyer's stick, who is busting full speed now. And he was around Raglan before he had a chance to make any turn at all.
Efficiently. Puck slides right back to Palladiev, intercepted again by Ellis, who's out there with Peter Mahovlich. Ellis 6, Peter Mahovlich 20, Bergman and Park the defense. Canada leading 2-0. There's a breakaway up the center. Zeeba gets away from a shot. Oh, and he was hurried by Park and failed to get it. Rakitin scores! Yakishev was standing in front and was able to meet.
This is a good example of why you should always follow the play up. Zeman has a clear-cut breakaway. He shoots wide. Now watch Yakishev park himself in front of the net. Lapierre gets the puck right to Yakishev, sweeps it to the far side. Tony Esposito had no chance. Again, we see it here from another angle. He shoots wide. He's going for that top corner. Now look where Yakishev parks himself and sweeps it for the far corner. No goalie would have had a chance.
Over on the far side, right in front of the goal, went wide of the net. Zeman knocked it back to the goal. It rolls off to the side. They failed to clear it out. Lapointe failed to get it away. Then Esposito cleared out. It's a race down with Peter Mahovlich going in on goal. Right in! He scores! Peter Mahovlich!
What an effort by Peter Mahovlich! What can you say? That Russian is still wondering where the puck is. Peter Mahovlich made an absolutely beautiful move. He has picked up the puck inside his red line. Now look at him isolate Palladiev. He gets him to put his legs together, isolates them, and then walks right around him. And what a move he made on Tretiak. Tretiak was completely fooled. Look at the move. He holds him with the big slap shot. Walks around with the big reach. Now look at the move here.
holds it and jams it into the high.
Puck is near the Soviet goal. Kuzka laying it over on the far side. And it's broken up by Makita. Anderson will stop. He's the rookie out there for the first time. The right foot for Mahovlich. He scores! Mahovlich. Mike Mahovlich has scored a fourth goal.
And both the Mahovlich brothers are dangerous tonight. And watch how he looks for a man out in front. Frank Mahovlich will walk right into the spot. And he drills one for the far corner, and it just catches the post. As the play develops here, they don't get it out. Makita now has deflected it into the corner. Now he's looking all the time. He misses it, comes back in his skate. Now he's got Mahovlich set up perfectly.
He got six games to play. Enjoy it tonight. Save Redfoot. He got a lot of games to play.
So now we finish off in Toronto with Team 2. Makita played, Savard, Lapointe, and head out to Winnipeg feeling much better. As I was saying earlier, that the day of that game, Hadfield made it clear that he was not very happy. And I've always remembered the most surprising thing of those two players is I expected an attitude like that from Rod Gilbert, and I didn't expect it from Hadfield, and it was the opposite. Rod Gilbert said, Al, if I never play another game in this series, it means we're winning, so I'll be happy. All I want to do is win. Hadfield, on the other hand, was very sour with everybody, and that almost became an infection. And by the time we got to Vancouver, we did have two teams, and then we got into Sweden, and we had almost a revolt. There's Bobby Hall. This is in Winnipeg. Ben Hatskin.
Canada break with one man back. A pass is intercepted as Sagankov was right in position to intercept that pass. Now the puck goes loose into the Soviet zone. Yakushev is starting to move. Shadron is out there with him. Canadians get a shot, a weak shot to the side. Here's another drive by Bill White. The right shot, the score! Was right on the edge of the goal crease, and Canada's drawn first blood. Bill White.
This was a high-rising shot by Bill White. A perfect shot. Now Kretjak can't control the rebound. He juggles it. Parise standing on the doorstep. Bangs the puck in the far corner. Here's another angle. Kretschak cannot control a high-rising shot by White.
Canada leading the Soviets 1-0. A goal by Parise from White at 1:54. Puck is back to Park. Cleared over on at the blue line. Intercepted. Here's a long shot. He scores! A long shot from the right side by Petrov. Right from the faceoff.
Can't make careless passes around the blue line. Frank Mahovlich misses the pass here. Petrov walks right in. Now look at the triangle, the way Tony Esposito goes down.
Brad Park, 5, over on the left side. Henderson trying to come in as they change players on the go. It rolls right across the goal mouth. Gusev, number 2, playing it over on the right wing. Shadron was replaced, and now Lebedev is dumped by Henderson. Here's Canada coming in out of break. Right in that goal, right in, he scores! Right in front of the net. And Rattel went dropping in on the pass, and it was home straight.
Team Canada takes control deep in their end. Now a good play by Ivan Cornwallier. Now look at Rattel control the puck. Sees the opening in the top side. And beats Tretiak with a good, clean shot.
From the faceoff, here's a shot from the blue line. Went wide there as it hit a leg. It nearly fooled Tretiak. Park with the defense on the trench with Bergman. The puck goes in back of the goal. Cashman took his man out of the play, Vasiliev. And they're jabbing in the opposite corner. Gusev is watched by Parise. And he scores! Eppolito got a pass from the corner and fired it home to give Canada a 3-1 lead. Esposito,
a perfect example of your wingers working in the corners. Look at him fight for the puck right here. He gets it. Cashman out to his favorite, Esposito. Drills it to the top right-hand corner. Tretiak had no chance.
Mahovlich is chased into the corner by Sagankov. They center it out, and Harlamov goes racing away on a breakaway, coming in on goal. He shoots, he scores! Harlamov came out from nowhere there to draw the goalkeeper out.
Harlamov, great player, eh? He's one of the greatest players I've played against.
Now Harlamov plays the carom off the boards perfectly. Now watch the good move. He protects the puck as he comes across in front. Esposito has made his move, and Harlamov goes right across the goal mouth and throws it up.
From the faceoff, the puck slides into the Canadian zone. 6:18 remaining in the second period. Here's a loose puck for Henderson. Right in. Scores! Henderson went racing in there to get a loose puck, and he fired it home for Canada to bring back that two-goal lead.
The Soviet defenseman isn't quite ready here. He doesn't realize initially that the puck got in behind him. Threaded the needle perfectly. Tretiak comes out, covers the angle perfectly, and Paul Henderson threaded the needle with a super shot in the far corner.
23, here's a shot, and he scores! A carom shot. Went from the blue line there. It was Vasiliev that fired from the blue line, and I believe it went off the Canadian player.
This is a deflected goal. Tony Esposito really didn't have any chance in this. Vasiliev lets a good shot go. Tony Esposito makes his move in anticipation of where the puck was going. It deflects into the far corner.
Soviets have six new players in there. Puck goes into the corner. It's passed in front. It rolls loose. Here's another pass right in front. He shot the score! And they tied it up. Bodnov let it go almost before he could move. And Bodnov has tied the score for the Soviet.
Bodnov positions himself perfectly here, and Lebedev gets him the puck. Now watch him stand in position. Number 24, a quick shot, and he beats Phil Esser, Tony Esposito, up into the top corner. Esposito's glove moved on it, but not quickly enough.
Winnipeg game was a disappointment because we had the game won.
I'm still saying we were not in shape like we were supposed to be still there.
I didn't know then I was going to play 2 years there in Winnipeg.
And then we got out into Vancouver, and it was like playing in an empty room, even though all the seats were full. It's like Pittsburgh. It's a funny arena that way. You don't get the feeling of the crowd.
Petrov is now at center ice for the Soviet. They have the odd man advantage. So Canada under a disadvantage right off the bat. Bill White goes back to the net. Mahovlich couldn't recover the puck. Kuzgin to Mihailov, 13. The pass goes loose. Bill White lobbed it down the ice. And Tretiak will have to stop it. Luchenko takes it back to the goal. Number 3, watched by Mahovlich. He's out there with Bill Esposito trying to kill off the penalty. From the corner, the puck is shot to the blue line, recovered by Blinov. Up to center to Petrov. Over the line, he stops. They're getting that passing play here. Luchenko's drive scores! A long shot by Luchenko. And whether it was deflected by a stick, it's hard to say.
Again, good puck control by the Soviets. They cross the blue line with good puck control. Now Luchenko moves into the prime scoring area. Mihailov has parked himself on the left of the net. And I don't know whether he actually tipped it or not, but he distracted Dryden as he tried to come across the net and stop the deflection. Good slap shot, low in a good place for a deflection.
Coming up at the blue line, pass on the left wing to Mihailov at center. Over on that right wing, they're closing in. Every man is up now for the pass. Here's Luchenko getting his shot. He scores! Luchenko let one go on a beautiful passing play. And the Soviet have taken a 2-0 lead.
Again, an example of perfect puck control. Look at them set up the puck control. Harlamov gets it right across. Luchenko moves in. Now again, Mihailov gets the stick down, deflects it up over Dryden.
Now the coming up at center ice
by Jill Perot. The length of the ice. Good work here. Now Vasiliev trying to stop it. It hits his skate and up into the top corner off the Soviet defenseman. Again, a beautiful effort by Jill Perot. A good burst of speed, but the Soviet deflected into the net.
All set now for the faceoff. 13:35 left in the second period. Henderson back to Stapledon. It's blocked by Petrov. A two-on-one. Bill White back. Ice on a shot. It's goal! Right from that left wing. A perfect play by Blinov. And the Soviet have got that one back very quickly.
That is going to hurt Team Canada. A perfect pass under the defenseman's stick. Blinov makes no mistake, a hard drive right between Dryden's legs. What you'll see here, now watch Petrov put it inside White's stick and his leg. That's the perfect place to play the pass.
Sealing into the corner with Vikulov after him. Sealing still trying to get that puck out of there. Maltsev took it from him. Varlamov turning, getting a backhand right in front. They score! Vikulov from Varlamov. Firing it in, and it all looks so easy.
This is an example. Now three Canadians go into the corner. Of course, the three of them are in the corner, the opening in front of the net. Varlamov, good puck control. Vikulov sweeps it in the short side. He caught Dryden going down, and he put it up over his pad.
Vikulov passes over. Here's Maltsev breaking right in on Clark. He went right in, and fired one off. Dryden's pass. He went right past Park there. Now another Esposito shooting. That's his long shot. Esposito.
Bill Goldsworthy fortunately came in behind to make sure. A good play. Now he drops it back to Esposito in the slot. And a terrific high-rising shot by Esposito. Hits the crossbar. Goldsworthy comes in and buries it for the second time. He drops it in the slot here, and Esposito rips his shot off the top of the crossbar.
Yakushev with Anderson at center over on the left side to Shadrin. Yakushev couldn't get a shot, Park deflecting it. Yakushev takes it on the boards, bounce off the skate, knocked back to the blue line. Maladia got it to one side. It's the loose puck still in there. Back of the net, Yakushev set it right in front of him, an open chance, they score! They found that opening. Shadrin was able to come right in there, nobody near him.
Again, an example of leaving a man clear in front. Look at Shadrin, good pursuit of the puck. Now Shadrin comes from the right out in front. He misses it, and tremendous concentration to throw that puck in up over Dryden on the second shot. Dryden makes a first good save, but there's no one there to help him.
Esposito with 27 seconds at center ice. Over on the left wing, Dennis Hull right in on goal, he's gone! Dennis Hull.
A good, quick shot by Dennis Hull. He caught the goalie. Phil Esposito gives him a perfect pass, holds the two defensemen to the middle, lays it into Hull. Now watch this shot. He gets Tretiak backing up into the net and throws it right up top. Good shot by Dennis Hull.
8:38 is the time. Dennis Hull.
For the people across Canada, we tried. We did our best. And for the people that boo us, geez, all of us guys are really disheartened and we're disillusioned and we're disappointed in some of the people. We cannot believe the bad press we've got. The booing we've gotten in our own buildings, and if the Russians boo their players, if the fans Russians boo their players like some of the Canadian fans, I'm not saying all of them, some of them booed us, then I'll come back and I'll apologize to each one of the Canadians, but I don't think they will. I'm really disappointed. I am completely disappointed. I cannot believe it. Some of our guys are really, really down in the dumps. We know, we're trying, but hell, I mean, we're doing the best we can, and they got a good team, and let's face facts. But it doesn't mean that we're not giving it our 150%, because we certainly are. They can throw the money for the pension fund out the window. They can throw anything they want out the window. We can, because we love Canada. And even though we play in the United States and we earn money in the United States, Canada is still our home, and that's the only reason we come. And I don't think it's fair that we should be booed.
I never seen that interview before.
No? Oh, yeah, it's great. I mean...
That series probably the highlight of his career.
The guy who really carried us in the tough times was Espo. Now we go to the Soviet Union, and we had 3,000 Canadians in the stands, 3,300 out of a total. Is this where Espo gets the flowers and falls?
That's not the story of our trip to Moscow.
Phil mentioned we had a got together one time, and Phil said, you know, have you ever thought what would have happened if we hadn't have won? And I said, you know, Phil, that never entered my mind, that it we were going to win. Somehow we were going to win, and we did win. And so losing was just not wasn't a part of the equation at all.
For Jean-Paul Parise, who just buried it right between Tretiak's legs.
2 minutes and 31 seconds played in the second period. 1-0 for Canada. And the pass to Clark, who spiked right in front of him. Goal! Clark just pulled his way right in. And Tretiak couldn't stop that shot from Clark. A great individual effort by Bobby Clark. He drives for the net, he holds off the check, and at the last moment, he throws the puck right between Tretiak's legs.
That was a nice play, Clarky. You didn't have too many moves like that in your career. Taking the puck from the faceoff, sliding by a forward and a defenseman.
4 minutes and 29 seconds left in the second period, and Paul Henderson has been taken to the dressing room, but he went out more or less under his own steam. Ready for the face-off. Bernoulli moves out of position on the first move. It's recovered by Kuzkin. Number four for the Soviet. A quick pass to center ice. One man back. Petrov getting it back to Klinov. Right in front of the score! Up to corner after Esposito had to make the move, and that will stir up the Soviets to a supreme effort.
Pat Stapleton had been beaten at the blue line. Tony Esposito gambles and lost. He tries to come out, slide out and make a poke check. Klinov very alertly hangs onto the puck, goes by and slips the puck into the net.
Clark takes a long pass to Henderson. He's in the clear, right in on goal. He can score! Henderson! From Clark, a beautiful set of play by Clark. And Henderson came back from the victory to score his second goal of the night.
Here's why it's so important to head man the puck. Henderson was breaking on his wing. He had a lot of ice. Bobby Clark puts a dump pass way up into the middle. Henderson skates on top of it and walks in all alone and drills another goal by Tretiak. You notice Tretiak backs up into the net a little bit, right between his legs. Now look at this pass. Henderson now cuts back in the middle, get a good angle, and he got Tretiak backing up into the net.
Yakushev again took it off the board. Centered it along the side, and it was Hamilton.
This is why every coach should have his forwards practice a tip-in. Anderson Park, what I thought would be out of position, puts the puck right back between his legs. Tony Esposito didn't have a chance on it. Good point goal.
Keeping the pressure on here. Harlamov getting it out to the blue line. There's a long shot. They score! They find the score! Kuzmin shot from the blue line. I don't know whether it was deflected.
contest this puck. We might see it on the replay. Gustav let a high-rising shot go, and it was deflected up into the top corner on the short side on Tony Esposito.
Clark is off on the wing. Shot it back into the hole.
Any mistakes if you give them the puck. He walked right in, brought the puck to the outside. He caught Tony Esposito trying to do the split to cover it, and he put it between his legs.
At that point, not too many people believed that we were going to come back.
Except our guys.
The thing that we all felt after that game was that we were good enough to beat them.
Yeah.
I think that game did a lot for us. I think every player on our team after that game was convinced that we could do it.
At no time did I ever believe that we were going to lose the series.
Three-man break for the Soviets. Two on one. Yakushev coming in on the defense, and his shot went wide. As he tried to pick the left corner, Yakushev knocked Courtois over. Another drive from the blue line. It's over!
So now we're, this is the 3-2 game. Now we had a little luck in this game. When we were a man short, they got a goal that the guy Harlamov flipped up high, and Dryden picked it off that netting that hung down, but the puck was in the net, and the goal judge hadn't seen it.
Now, Rick Gilbert at center, over the line. The shot hit the defenseman. Another chance for Gilbert. A shot right on. Another one. The score! Canada tied it up. Rochelle was in on that. Canada tied the score from a scramble, and Phil Esposito was right in on top of the goalkeeper. I believe it's Dennis Paul who gets the goal here, and he picks the rebound right out of the air. Throws it right up on the top of the net. A beautiful goal by Dennis Paul. He stood right in the right position. He anticipated the rebound and came out good. He picked it out of the air. And the speed is developing out of the end zone. Rod Gilbert, good puck control up the right hand side. He shot his block. Now, Paul comes out of nowhere, throws it up top.
A shot from the blue line was blocked by Stable and getting it away. Back of the net, Barrington shoots it door! Cornwallé got it in from Red Barrington. Cornwallé for Canada from Barrington to give the Canadian team a 2-1 lead. Canada now leads 2-1. Two fairly fast goals, Dennis Hull and then Cornwallé and Barrington. And two of the three have been added starters. Now then, Canada coming up. It's good to go! Henderson! Let's go on a long drive. And Canada takes a 2-goal lead. From the face-off, here's a shot deflected. Yakushev recovers. They're getting that pattern play right in front of the goal. It's good to go! It gets right in there. Looks like Yakushev did the trick. Yakushev puts the Soviet within one goal of Canada by coming in front of the net and scoring on that play with the help of Shadron. That's what happens when you get a penalty against them. Grabbing each other, hugging each other with the final score, Canada 3 and the Soviets 2. This is game 6 from Moscow.
Well, one thing that we can say, we never quit at it.
The fans in Russia were shocked to see the people yelling and screaming and
the
only whistle. Eh?
But by the time the series was underway, they started to make as much noise as we did. But they had 11,000 seats in the rink. We had 3,300 of them. We outshouted them by quite a bit. Now we've won one in their rink, and that's when all the shenanigans began. They realized that maybe there was a chance we could win. We showed up for practice the next day, and they had kids all over the ice, and said that they'd mixed up the practice, and we weren't going to be able to practice that day. And I can remember getting Dennis Hull and Roger Gilbert to go out and fire a few slap shots. Suddenly, the kids had other things to do.
Are we going to see you on the ice? Is it that game or?
That's in the archives. I don't know. Oh, I think we'll get there.
Coming up on the right side, cleared it over on the far wing to Henderson, to Esposito, a shot left wide, and the puck goes into the corner. They're trying to get into position there. Henderson into Ellis in the corner, a pass right in front to Esposito, he scores! Esposito on Ellis, and there's Canada drawing first blood. Esposito from Ellis.
A great play by Ronnie Ellis, getting the puck out to Phil Esposito. He's parked about 15 feet out in front of the net, and what a move he makes, turning around to get the shot back in the goal. He had Tretiak at his mercy. Here it comes again. We can see Ellis charge into the corner. Good forechecking here. Canada setting up control. Gets the puck out to Esposito. He makes a big turn and fires it home.
Canada was about to make a change. The play goes right on. Yakutchev coming down fast. Here they go! Yakutchev for the Soviets. Well, whoever said that the Soviets can't let the slap shot go, they've got to be wondering right now, Foster. Yakutchev pulled away from the Canadian player. Let a slap shot go that caught Tony Esposito. He had yet to get ready. And it went right between his legs. Mikhailov at center with Petrov. He gets that puck right in that goal right here. He gets the score. Went right in to score, drawing the goalkeeper out. And it was a beautiful goal by Petrov.
Great puck control by Petrov. He almost has the puck poked away from him. But look at him fight for control. He gets the puck again and slips it right in behind Tony Esposito, who by now has been way out of the net and is well out of position. A beautiful goal by Petrov to give the Soviets the lead.
16:27, the time of Petrov's goal to give the Soviets the lead, 2-1. Cleared over on the far side. It's back to Savard. He fakes the shot, turn. There's going to be a penalty call here. Esposito shoots, he scores! Esposito fires that puck and it's all tied up again. Esposito let one go from about 30 feet out.
Again, his teammate gets Esposito the puck and he's right in the key scoring area. Phil Esposito with that quick wrist shot. We see it come up here again. Savard makes a good move here, beating the defenseman, gets it back to Esposito, and the quick shot beats Tretiak on the low side in the corner.
Well, that scoring fail, the Esposito from Savard. Rattel drives it into the Soviet zone. Dennis Hull tears in after it, and it's grabbed off by Gilbert right in front of the net. He passed instead of shooting, and Rattel couldn't get it. Now Gilbert again to the off the board, came right around his spot, and was in the net.
A good play behind the net here by Team Canada. Rod Gilbert stepping out from the corner. Now watch Tretiak, he's well back in the net. Team Canada dumps it in and chases it. All important, you have to chase the puck. Now Gilbert misses it, gets it right across. So Gilbert parked himself behind the net. It comes right out to him, and he buries the backhand right between Tretiak's legs.
The check go over to Maltsev in the corner. Maltsev trying to center it back to Lachenko. Takes the shot here. Liapkin getting a shot. And it went just off Esposito's leg. They still keep it in. They're keeping that pressure on. Luchenko takes a shot, backs up to the blue line, cleared it to the corner. They're still zigzagging around. Here's a shot, they score! Yashchenko, standing on the side of the crease. Yashchenko from Malta. The Soviets have good puck control on this power play, and they get Team Canada running around a little bit. You can see Yashchenko. Now he goes over right in front of the goal crease, and bingo, right up into the net.
Henderson going down. To the defense, goes right out of the goal!
Henderson, right through the score for Canada. A beautiful goal by Paul Henderson.
And he's being mobbed by his teammates. But this is an absolutely beautiful move by Henderson. And the goal judge was a little slow in putting the light on, but there's no question that puck was right up into the top and the back of the net. And Tretiak really had no chance on that quick little maneuver by Paul Henderson. We can see Henderson move in here, and he just flips it right up top. Tretiak had no chance on it.
Paul Henderson was the hero on that one. He made a beautiful play.
I think the greatest goal I ever scored in my life was the winning goal I scored in the seventh game to make it all worthwhile. I mean, I've never beaten two defensemen and then beaten the goaltender in my life. And as I watch it time and time again, it is very satisfying. And of course, I'm remembered as something very positive. I talk about the goal probably 300 days of the year. And as I get farther away from it, I think I appreciate it more. I mean, goodness gracious, did I really do that?
Over on the far side, the shot is stopped, the drive, they flag it in, the score! Yashchenko left in the rebound to give the Soviet a 1-0 lead. You'll see Yashchenko, the first shot doesn't go in, and Yashchenko perks himself right on the goal mouth, picks up the rebound, and bangs the goal. The leading scorer in the series now with 10 points. That gives Yashchenko his sixth goal of the series. Good play by the Soviets here. They set up good puck control. They have Canada at their mercy. Now Yashchenko moves in, parks himself, and hits the post, and he banks in the rebound.
Bill Esposito out there with Parisi as the puck goes back to Vikilov. Maltsev takes his pass. He's knocked over by, it'll be a penalty there to Canada.
Getting his penalty. He has no respect for the referee. He could get himself right up the gate.
Zagankov is off for interference. Here's a pass back to Park. Cleared on the right side to Ellis. Right in front of the net for Phil Esposito as Canada at full strength for a change. And the Soviet a man short. Canadians having a chance. Here's a shot. Right on. Protect. They bang it in. Phil Esposito knocked in the rebound. And the score is tied. Phil Esposito. And that ties the score.
I'm not sure if we won't see number three, Luchenko, help Phil Esposito put that in the net. Tretiak makes a good first save, but he can't clear the puck away. His defenseman comes in to help him and sweeps the puck, I think, right back into the net with the help of Phil Esposito.
Luchenko going into the corner, played it back on the board, go to Zagankov, a shot, went wide. Harlamov getting it again on that far wing, passing back to Luchenko, here's another shot, he scores!
It sets up and gets it back to that center man. Luchenko lets a terrific shot go. Now they set it up again. They're looking again for that man in the middle. And here comes the shot right to amaze the players.
Here
it past center ice. Another try by Park. They're closing in. Rattell to Park. Right in. He scores! Park from Rattell. And Canada tied it up. Park from Rattell for Canada. This is a beautiful two-way play by Jean Rattell and Brad Park. And you can tell that they're teammates because they knew exactly what they were doing. Rattell slipped the puck through to Park, and Park buried it in the far corner of the net. A great goal for Team Canada by Brad Park.
The puck is now from the faceoff into the Soviet zone. Vasiliev cleared in front of his own net. It's grabbed off by Henderson momentarily. Yakushev comes away on the right wing, closes in with his shot wide. It bounced in front of the net. Shattered, he scores! Was unable to clear the puck, and it was shot right back at him. What we see coming off the back screen, Dryden doesn't see the puck come back. It comes back right to the middle, and Chatterin drills it home.
Rattell got the draw. Still there. Van's there. Still backing up. Takes a shot, and right by the door! Bill White deflected it into the net. Bill White from... And the score is all tied up. White from Gilbert to tie the score for Canada. You won't see a more beautiful scoring play in hockey than this play by Bill White, set up perfectly by Rod Gilbert. Canada and the Soviets are tied, 3-3. Canada carrying the play at this stage. He's a roll right by the net. Does he score? Yes, he can. But right in front of the net. And there's that deadly shot again from close in to give the Soviet a 4-3 lead.
Yakushev has to be the Soviet's most dangerous player. He's parked right at the top of the goal screen. He's not trying to get his mercy.
Yakushev goes back to the blue line, trying to draw his man away. Yakushev still has it on that far side. Passes back on the boards. There's that tic-tac-toe passing play. Vasiliev is going to take a shot. There'll be another penalty on the play. They shoot the score. Shadron deflected it into the net. Shadron deflected that one into the net.
Vasiliev, number six, has Dryden at his mercy. And all the time, Shadron is walking right in towards the post and takes the tip in and buries the shot for a very, very important goal in this game.
Cornwallé to Peter Mihalovic, coming down the right wing, keeps on going into the corner, is bumped back to the net, centered in front. Here's Esposito getting his head. Oh! Esposito! Esposito scores for Canada, 2:27.
Peter Mihalovic does a lot of work in the corner here. He sets it up. Now Esposito has to bang it once and then again, and he gets Fred Jack right off guard.
Park is trying to come out on the left side. A long pass to Phil Esposito going in. He shoots. Oh, right in front of the net. Esposito banged that. Here's another shot by Cornwallé. His goal! Canada has tied it up. The Canadian team grabbing each other there as the loose puck went around the net.
Phil Esposito, once he takes for it, now and he keeps fighting. He gets it out. It's shot. And Cornwallé puts the backhander into the goal.
Here we are. Here's my...
There's
Peter. He's already over hitting. Look at Bergie. I was by then down near. They were beating me up pretty well. And I was down on the ground. And then Peter, look, he jumped right over the boards, hit one with his stick. I can remember my mother saying, I knew you were all right when I saw you tucking in your shirt.
Whatever it was, nobody knows. But Canada tied that score at 12:56. And it appeared to be Cornwallé who got the goal. Cornwallé has it on that wing. Here's a shot. Henderson made a wild stab for it, fell. Here's another shot right by the door. Henderson has scored for Canada. Henderson right in front of the net. And the fans of the team are going wild.
And I shouldn't have been on the ice. I mean, that's an incredible thing about it, is when, I've never done it before, and I've never done it since, call the player off the ice, before it was his turn to come off. I mean, they were out there, and there was no need for him to come off, but I yelled at Peter Mihaljevic, and I really felt that I could score a goal.
Eight games and decided in the last 20 seconds says something for the ability. But that was great hockey, every game, every shift.
We see a lot of people still today, and they remember exactly where they were and where they were at specific time when Anderson scored.
It doesn't seem like 15 years, does it? Sometimes it seems. I wished it wasn't.
For us, it was the first time that we really had a chance to play at that caliber. It was almost a shock to see them going around us on power plays, and they're great puck handler, they're great skaters, and everybody thought that they were going to be just average hockey player, but they were a great team.
It was a roller coaster ride of emotion, and it was. I mean, we had more ups and downs than most hockey seasons.
As far as it being the greatest hockey series of all time, I don't know for sure. But again, one thing I can guarantee, it was the greatest series that I've ever played in.